So Excel recently released a few new functions called Lambda Helper Functions. And I'm curious what you think when you hear that, Lambda Helper Functions. Do you think that sounds great, I'm immediately going to use those? Or do you think they sound too technical, I don't need them, I'm just going to use my standard functions? Share with me because I'd love to know. Now, I'll probably cover all these functions at some point, but today I want to concentrate on two of these functions, by rows and by columns. I want to show you a practical use for these and check what you think, if you can actually see yourself using these in the future. Now, just to mention, these functions have just rolled out, so check the description of this video to find out more details about their availability. Let's jump in. We have the sales data by month for the different sales employees. And what we want to do is first get the months that were above the sales target. So this is our sales target. It's dynamic. We can easily change it. And here we want to get the months that passed the sales target. And we want to do this in a single formula. This is where by column can come in handy. Now, the second example is going to be for us to get the employee names that sold above the target. So basically, we're going to look at each of these months and see, was there any month where that employee sold above the target? And we want to see their names down here as well. Okay, so let's start with the first objective. Now, because we have months in columns, the function that we can use here is BYCOL. Now, let's see what that does. So here, I'm just going to start off by typing in BYCOL. You can see right here, it says that it applies a lambda function to each column and returns an array of the results. Now, don't get scared about the lambda part because it's actually really simple to set that up. All this needs is an array, and this is going to be our chunk here, because what BYCOL does is that by default, it's going to split this whole array into single columns. And then it's going to pass each single column to whatever function you want. Now here comes the function, and that's the lambda function. So here you start off with lambda and then you define the function. So when you're building your lambda, which is your machine that's going to process each column of this range, you no longer need to reference the range, right? We've already done it here. We need to create variables or parameters for this, and you can call this whatever you want. I'll just call it my call. Then we can add the calculation. This calculation has to be any type of aggregation or calculation that you can apply to a single column. So for example, you could sum the columns, or you could get the maximum value of the columns. Now, just to demonstrate what happens, if I do sum, now don't highlight this or reference this, we go with this name here, my call, because that's going to split this range into each separate column, and it's going to sum each single column in this case. So now I'm going to close bracket again, press enter, and I get the sum of each column spilled, right? So that's easily visible here. That's the sum. This is the sum of the second column, and so on. So now instead of sum, we want to do a check. We want to basically count how many times we went over this target here. Instead of using the sum function here, I can use a combination of count with an if, or I can use the count if function. My range is my call, and my criteria is whether it's greater than this. So I have to put the greater than sign in quotation marks, and then because I'm combining text with a cell reference, I need the ampersand, and I'm going to reference this. Now, ideally, you probably want to use the let function as well to define a name for this. But in this case, I'm just going to keep it simple and reference the cell directly. This closes the count if function. Then we have the lambda function, so we need another bracket. Press enter and check this out. We get the number of occurrences where we were above this target. So here, there must be two numbers that are above this. One is this one, and the other is this one. Then here, there was nothing that was above the target, and so on. I'm getting there, but I want to get the months back, and I don't want to get these numbers back. What I can do is to combine this with the filter function. So So I want to filter whatever I want to get back, which is the months here. My criteria here, what I want to include, is basically based on the result of bicolumn, but I want to check whether bicolumn is greater than zero. Then as the last argument, if it's empty, so if there are no matches found, I want to return nothing, close bracket, press enter, and I have the months where I was above target. Now in this case, I get it horizontally, but you can easily use the transpose function and get this vertically as well if you need to. Let's just double check whether this is dynamic. Instead of 1,500, I'll change this to 1,900, and I just get April, May, and July. Let's press Ctrl Z to go back. So this is how you can use the bicolumn function and how you can combine it with other functions as well. Now that we know how this one works, it's really easy to find the employee names that sold above the target. So let's do that right here. I'm going to do this from scratch, but you probably know how that works now. We need by row instead of columns because the employees are by row here. The array is the same thing. And the lambda function, we're going to give it a parameter. So I'll just call it my row. You can call it whatever you want. The calculation is the same. I'm going to use the COUNTIF function, check whether my row is greater than. So I need the greater than sign and my target here, close bracket and close bracket again and again. Now here I get to see how often an employee went above target. So first case, I have Doug here and he went above target 2 times. So that's 1 time and that's the 2nd time, right? So it all looks great. Now I'm gonna put this again inside the filter function. The array are my names here because that's what I wanna get back. The include argument is gonna check whether this array is greater than 0. And if no matches are found, I'm gonna return an empty string. Let's close bracket, press enter, and I get to see the names. And if this changes again, let's go back to 1,900. I just get dog and cat. So that's an example how you can use by rows and by columns in Excel. So let me know in the comments below what you think and if you can see yourself using these in the future. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, by the way, if you aren't subscribed already, so you can stay up to date with new developments in Office. Thank you for watching, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.